Now refer this second question, which is on the cycloid curve. So the question is, a wheel of diameter 56 mm rolls downward on a straight vertical wall for half revolution and then on the horizontal floor for remaining half revolution. Draw the locus of point P on the circumference. Initial position of the P is contact between wall and the wheel. Okay. So the condition given here is, suppose this is a vertical wall and this is the wheel. Okay. So this wheel is in contact with this vertical wall. Now this wheel is rolling in the downward direction like this. Okay. So it will roll in the downward direction for half revolution. So for half revolution, the starting point of the curve is the contact between the vertical wall and the wheel. Okay. So this point of contact, it is the starting point. So if this is rolling, so curve will be traced like this for half revolution. So after half revolution, this point, it will shift exactly 180 degree. So this is the point after half revolution. So you will get this curve for half revolution. Okay. So this point, suppose it is starting point P, after half revolution, so this point will be the P6. Okay. And again for half revolution, this circle will be rolling. So this is the position of the point after half revolution. Okay. Now after this point, it will roll on the rightward direction on the horizontal surface. So for remaining half revolution, surface is a horizontal. So this is the horizontal surface for remaining half revolution. This is the point. Okay. And this is the rotation for remaining half revolution. So we have to draw this curve, which is a continuous curve for half revolution vertical, half revolution horizontal. So let us see the construction. So first step is draw one vertical line. So this line is nothing but the wall. Okay. Then draw the wheel, which is a circle having the diameter 56 mm. Okay. Now this contact point is the starting point for the curve. So name this point as a P. This circle will roll in the downward direction on this vertical surface for half revolution. Okay. So after half revolution, what is the distance covered by the center point? Okay. So that distance is equal to the half of the circumference. Okay. So take the distance, which is half of the circumference. So take the distance on this vertical line, which is a pi d by 2. So right now diameter is 56 mm. So this is equal to approximately 88 mm, pi d by 2. Okay. So from this point, draw one horizontal line. So this line will represent the position of the center point after half revolution. Okay. So from this center point, draw one horizontal line. So you will get this center after half revolution. Okay. And with this as a center, the radius is same. We have to draw the circle. So this circle will shift at this position after half revolution. Okay. Now we have to trace out the curve. For that, divide the circle into 12 equal parts. You can name this point. Okay. Now from each point 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, draw the vertical line, which is parallel to this straight line. Okay, so in this way, draw these vertical lines. Now divide this distance. Actually, in half revolution, half revolution we have divided into 6 equal part. Okay, so divide this line pi d by 2 into 6 equal divisions. So you can draw this horizontal inclined line, take some distance 1 centimeter or 5 millimeter and draw the arc. So name this point. So this is 1 dash, this is 2 dash, 3 dash, 4, 5 and 6. Okay. Now from each point 1, 2, 3, 4, draw the horizontal line that will intersect the line which is passing through the center of the circle. So if this is the starting position for the center, so take this C, after 1 by 12th revolution, C center will shift at this position. So this is C1, again after 1 by 12th, it will shift at this position. So this is C2, this is C3, this is C4, this is C5 and this is C6, okay. Now we have to find out what is the position for the point P when the circle is rolling by 1 by 12th division. So when C is a center, this is the point P. When C1 as a center, this point P, it will shift on the right side, okay, and it will take the position somewhere on this line which is passing through point 1 or point 11. So take the same radius, which is the radius of the circle, shift the center to C1 and draw the arc on the line which is passing through the point 1 or 11. So you will get this intersection. This is the next position for the point P. So this is a P1. With C2 as a center, point P1 will shift again on the right side. So draw the arc on the line passing through the point 2 or point 10. So this is the point P2. When C3 as a center, point P2 will shift again on the right side on this line. So this point is a P3. With C4 as a center, point P3 will shift again on the right side. So draw the arc on this line which is passing through the point 4. So this is a P4. With C5 as a center, P4 will shift on this line which is passing through the point 5. So this is a P5. With C6 as a center, P5 will be exactly on this line which is passing through the point 6. So you will get the tangent. So point P, it will shift exactly 180 degree after half revolution. So this is a half revolution. So you can draw this smooth curve. So which will start from P, P1, P2, then P3, P4, P5 and P6. So this is for the half revolution. Okay. After half revolution, so this is the position after half revolution, okay. Now this circle is rolling in the horizontal direction, okay. So at this point, draw one horizontal line which is tangent to the circle. So this line will represent the horizontal surface or the floor. Now the circle is rolling in this direction. So already we have the division, so no need to divide again into 12 parts. Just mark these points. Okay, now from these points just draw the horizontal line. And now take the distance, which is the half of the circumference, that is equal to 88. So from this point, take the distance 88. Draw the vertical line. So this point is the center after again half revolution. Now draw the circle. So this is the final position of the circle. Okay, so initially circle will roll in the vertical direction and after that in the horizontal direction. Now divide this distance again into 6 equal parts. Okay, now take this position, this is 7, 8 dash, 9 dash, because this is the 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 and this is 12. Okay, now from each point 7, 8 draw the vertical line. So you will get the successive position for the center of the circle. So this is the C6 position. After C6, the center will shift at this position. So this is C7. After that, this is C8, this is C9, this is C10, this is C11, and this is C12. So this is the position after 12th revolution or 1/12th of revolution. Okay. Now take the center C7, take the same radius. When C6 was a center, point was P6. When C7 is a center, this point P6, it will shift in the downward direction because circle is rolling like this. Okay? So after P6, point will shift slightly below the point P6.